How do we make a crossfade? Well, it's pretty easy. We fade one sound out and fade another sound in at the same time, and ideally, the total change in volume should remain at null throughout the entire fade. This is quite basic mathematically, achievable with just two straight lines. If we multiply the audio sources with this blue fade out or this red fade in, upon adding them together, we get a gain change of 1, which is no change at all. Multiplying a number by 1 gives you that same number. I've developed quite a few things that rely on crossfading and windowing, like granular synthesizers and pitch shifting and time stretching algorithms and so on. In those cases, I've used a raised cosine crossfade instead, like so. Once again, the change in gain adds up to a constant 1, but there's significantly less artifacting because there isn't an abrupt corner where the fade begins. But for now, we'll just use a linear crossfade for simplicity. To demo this, let's crossfade this sine wave and this triangle wave linearly and observe that the blending between them remains consistent in volume. Okay, wonderful. Everything's working perfectly. There we go. Video's essentially over now. And obviously, as we saw from the math, this should work with any two audio signals. For example, crossfading between two white noise sources.
Actually correct.
How's my throat hurt already? Hey, what's up, my homies and dearies? We got ourselves a little problemo. As it turns out, something called phase cancellation exists. This is no good. When two sounds are crossfaded with each other, it can result in destructive interference and phase cancellation between them that wasn't present outside of the fade. If the two sounds you're crossfading between are highly correlated, like two waveforms with the same frequency and phase, a constant gain fade like the ones I showed already should work. However, this is rarely the case. Usually when we're performing a crossfade, it's between two sounds that are very uncorrelated, resulting in destructive interference during the entire fade. You can use Audacity's linear fades to check this out, the fade in and fade out effects in the effects list. You'll notice that the peak gain remains the same throughout the fade, but the RMS drops by 3 decibels, equivalent to multiplying it by the square root of 2 over 2. To fix this, we need a crossfade that doesn't have a constant gain, but instead has a constant power, the power being the signal squared. This will guarantee the RMS remains the same throughout the entire fade, so there won't be any audible dip in the middle. To achieve a constant power crossfade, we can simply take the square root of our constant gain fade functions. Upon adding them together, you'll see this bump in gain in the middle, which will perfectly counteract the RMS dip that the constant gain fades were causing. It may seem counterintuitive to have a crossfade that doesn't add up to a flat line, but the math does check out.
Now let's test this to see how it sounds!
Nice.
Now let's see how this sounds in the context of a granular pitch shifter. Here's a clip from a song I made in collaboration with Alan Moore last year.
She called me Mr. Bombastic, really fantastic. Touch me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Roe. Fantastic.
Here's that same clip, but pitch shifted granularly using the old raised cosine crossfades.
She called me Mr. Bombastic, tell me fantastic. Touch me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Romantic, tell me fantastic.
And now we'll try it again, but with equal power crossfades instead, since the grains being summed together are very likely to be uncorrelated.
We want some bombastic, romantic, fantastic lover. She called me Mr. Bombastic, tell me fantastic. Touch me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Romantic.
Much better.